Okay, guys, I had to show you my latest little acquisition here. This is a Ket-Tec, the KSG 12 gauge. So, pretty cool, man. So, of course, you get a plain old cardboard box, instruction manual, and I didn't notice this. It fell in the fell inside this little thing. But, yeah, little attachment, sling. It's cool. I wasn't expecting it, but hey. And, oh, what's this? Ket-Tec KSG 12. KSG 12. Anyway, it's a lot of firepower. I gotta say, myself, I'm more into pumps than semi-autos. I mean, if I can get the AA 12, you know, that'd be badass. I'd go for that for sure, but I can't. So, you know, the Sega, whatever, you know, those are okay, I guess. You hear sometimes got problems as a reliability kit, but some semi-autos can be kind of finicky depending on the ammo. I know there'll be some guys, I've had this gun and never had any problems. Well, okay, but, you know, some people do. I've had that problem, just especially with, like, AA, 12, just doing target shooting or some shit. You can have a couple, little bit of problems. But anyway, I used to have, or I still have the Maverick 88. 12 gauge, and I picked this sucker up a while back because I liked the capacity. It had 7 rounds and one in the chamber, so you know, 8 altogether. But this sucker, much more compact. It's like 21 inches overall, and double the firepower. Just about. I mean, you know, this tube holds 7. It has 2 tubes that hold 7, so 14, and then you know, 1. Keep chamber, there you go, 15 rounds in that guy versus 8 in this guy here. So, pretty badass. I've been looking for one of these for a while. There's a shooting range down in here in Austin called Reds, and they had one months ago, and somebody beat me by 20 minutes, 30 minutes, something like that. Here in Austin, there's a place called McBride's, an old gun store. They've got these guys just under 1,000. There's another shop, little mom and pop shop I like. It's called Tex Guns. And they have one, when they have them, it's right over 1,000. McBride's, they had one just under 1,000 today. And I picked this sucker up. There's a Cabela's close by in Buda. I haven't seen one of these out there. And then Red's, the indoor range, they had it for $750. So I hopped on that this time. Somebody beat me last time, but not this time. Now, I didn't have the coin to actually test shoot it. I mean, it kind of stretching as it is, I just picked it up, you know, throw it in the cart, I'll pay it off. I'm usually pay everything off at the end of the month. This would be one of the few times I don't. But anyway, hey, what the hell. I'll pay it off in the next month or so. But I couldn't leave it this time. It's been months. I may not see one for a while. So I got it. And, I mean, pretty badass. Look at how compact it is. You can put, it's got Picatinny Weaver rails. I mean, you can put all kinds of shit on here. Any light bipod. I mean, not that you really need it. I'm gonna put a foregrip on there. I haven't fired it. Like I said, I didn't have the money to rent the booth and buy the ammo. You can only do slugs there, and you know, I wasn't expecting to buy a gun, so I didn't go in there with ammo. And you know, there's slugs. They don't sell them for chicken feed, so I have to go back later. But anyway, just practicing with a dummy round. And some bird shot. You really have to rack this son of a bitch. That's what I've noticed right away. The Ket-Tec. You really got to rack it hard. Like, you know, I mean, put some force into it. It'll work every time, but you really got to mean it. So, you know, you just got to get used to it. Having any problems with it, you know, you really put force, no problems. But, you know, you do it lightly or something, you know, no. I'm not sure what the deal is, maybe. I don't know. But anyway, I mean, like this guy here, if you eject it, you know, you eject a new shell or shoot and eject the shell, it racks another one really slow and pulls the, you know, ejects the other shell really slow. This guy got to do it fast. So, I mean, that's cool. Once you get it down, you know, put some force, it's kind of cool anyway. I know I was talking about reliability, so I don't know. That's kind of the, But, I mean, for the capacity and just putting a little bit of force, if that's all you got to remember, that's still pretty damn reliable. Like I say, once I just back and forth hard all the way, well, no problem. If you're fucking around with it, then you know you got to do it a second time, which takes a second or two, but yeah, there'll be somebody, oh, a lot can happen in a second or two. Yeah, you're right. So just you know, get it down the first time. I didn't notice that right away. The guy, you know, me and the guy at the range, we didn't fire, but we just put dummy rounds. Like, huh? And we finally figured it out. Yeah. Anyway, pretty badass, and I'm gonna go back, test it, and let you guys know. I'll probably put a foregrip on it. That's really what I think would help out. It'll make it probably less of an issue. It's got a foregrip on there. You can rack it much more easily. It's not that it's hard, but you know, this kind of gets sometimes it's a little bit of a hassle. I mean, it'd be a lot easier with the foregrip. But anyway, I just thought I'd show you guys that. And like I say, man, for a little compact gun, I mean, 15 rounds, you know, 7.7 and one in the chamber. That's a lot of firepower, man. Fucking street sweeper. I mean, it's not the real street sweeper, but shit, much more efficient. The real motherfuckers were kind of dirty and threw shit on the sides like a revolver or something. But this is pretty badass, and even more firepower than that. I think that was 9, but fucking 4 or 15. Pretty badass. Anyway, I just had to show you that. I'll post a follow-up video after I fired it. So anyway, you guys have a good one.